Would everybody else put your right hand over your heart? Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Police Chaplain Officer Conrad Penn will now lead us in the invocation.
Good afternoon, and thank you everyone for being here on behalf of the Parcells family and the Long Beach Police Department. I want to thank everybody for attending here today to show your support and love for both Credo and the Parcells family. Today we gather to both remember and honor Credo and his dedication and service to this department. We also gather to lift up and encourage Mike and his family through their loss. We gather as a family to mourn their loss of a coworker and a friend. In the book of Philippians, scripture 4:13, says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I agree, but it doesn't mean we will not go through difficult times. This is a difficult time. So please let us bow our heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for the strength and encouragement for Mike and his family to get through this situation, a strength and encouragement only you can provide. We lift up this family and pray for healing and peace. I also pray for the safety of all the gathered people here today, especially law enforcement. I pray for them to continue to do the great job they do and remain diligent and focused. I pray for the protection of both them and their families. Thank you. Thank you, Father in heaven. And we ask for these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Please be seated. K-9 Officer Bill Kift will now read the K-9 prayer.
I will lay down my life for you and expect nothing but love in return. I protect all officers with my life and would gladly take a bullet in their place. I'm sent in to find lost children and fugitives on the run. I find drugs, weapons, and even bombs. I am the first in and often the last to leave. I am the nose and the ears of the officers. I protect and serve them. I would die for any and all officers. I only ask for your love and your care. A K-9 prayer.
I'd now like to introduce our Chief of Police, Robert Luna.
Thank you, Bill. As we sit here today, I think we all know, and the words don't have to be said, that we're going through a pretty challenging time in law enforcement. I would like to start my comments by actually asking everybody for a moment of silence for all the police officers who have recently lost their lives in protecting our communities. Thank you very much. According to the officer down memorial page, as of today, 19 police officers across the country have been killed in the line of duty since this incident occurred on June the 28th. Not in the whole year, just since June 28th. That means that in the last 22 days, 19 police officers have lost their lives in the line of duty. That is sad. Very sad. These are police officers who came to work, donned their uniform to serve, to protect, to make a positive difference in our communities, no matter who, what, or where you come from. They lost their life for a very noble cause. Today, we are here to talk about our own loss. Based on the facts that I know today, and as you know, in this line of work, they do change, regarding this incident on June 28th, members of the U.S. Marshals Fugitive Task Force requested our department's assistance with apprehending a gang member wanted in connection with the violent shooting that occurred, or that went back to 2014, involving multiple victims in our city. When task force members contacted the suspect, he fled, where he ultimately barricaded himself in a nearby apartment of an acquaintance. Several attempts were made to get him to surrender, but the suspect refused to cooperate. As this suspect was considered armed and dangerous, our SWAT team, which includes negotiators, mental evaluation team, and our K-9 unit, was activated. SWAT negotiators directed the suspect to exit the residence, which he did after several hours of attempting to de-escalate this situation. However, he failed to comply with the officer's verbal commands and began to aggressively charge our officers. Officer Parcells quickly recognized the danger as the suspect began to charge them and released Credo to take the suspect down. While Credo attempted to pull him away from the officers, the suspect produced a knife and continued to quickly advance towards the officers, utilizing Credo, who was hanging on the suspect's left arm, as a shield. In fear for his safety and the safety of his fellow officers, one of the officers discharged his weapon, striking both the suspect and Credo. Credo's action slowed down the suspect's attack on the SWAT officers, giving them time to react to this deadly threat. Credo's actions saved lives, making him a hero. The department tried to de-escalate the situation for several hours in an attempt to bring this to a peaceful conclusion, which is our ultimate goal with every encounter. Unfortunately, the suspect's actions dictated a very different outcome. Credo was a 4-year-old Belgian Malinois who served our community and the Long Beach Police Department for 2 years. Officer Parcells and Credo worked patrol and narcotics and was involved in over 30 apprehensions. Credo's partner, Mike Parcells, is a 23-year veteran of our police department and has been a canine handler for 16 years. Sadly, Credo is the second dog that Officer Parcells has lost in the line of duty. His canine partner, Ranger, was shot during a SWAT call-out back in 2005. Some may argue that a police canine is just a tool. But please understand, to Mike, his wife Lisa, and their children Justin and Ryan, Credo was a part of your family. And we are here today to share in your pain and in your loss. And as we talk about Credo, our dog, you have to remember, for all of you who have a pet and the connection you have to that pet. And Mike shared a story with me about Credo being Credo. After all, he was a dog. And he shared a story about the family leaving the house to go on a trip. And Credo, being as creative as he was, found a way to get into the house. He ransacked it. He ran around. It was his house. Apparently, he found out where Mike's uniforms were, and he did a number on his uniforms. Maybe that was a message. My partner left me behind today, and my family left me behind today. And apparently, to put an exclamation point on it, he urinated in special places in the house. But at the end of the day, I tell you that story because it shows a connection that the Parcells family had to Credo. It was their dog. It was our dog. And although we will miss Credo, I want you to know that Credo did not retreat in the face of danger. He performed his duty with courage and honor. And as I said before, Credo will be remembered as a hero. On behalf of all the men and women of the Long Beach Police Department, we appreciate the support of our law enforcement partners, our community, and our business leaders. We have received condolences from all over the country. Pretty amazing how word spreads. And have received donation offers to replace our beloved K-9. It is truly, truly very much appreciated. And I thank them all. I want to thank all of you for spending time with us today to grieve the loss of a family member of ours. And as I conclude my remarks, I want to leave you just with one other very important thing. There's been no time in our history that I can think of where the men and women in law enforcement need your support more than they do right now. We really need the silent majority to step up and talk about the appreciation you have for law enforcement. Mayor, I'd like to thank you for being here today. You have shown over and over that you are a very big supporter of this police department. And on behalf of the men and women, I thank you for your support. Thank you.
Our next speaker is retired police commander Steve Dittmars, who is also the president of the Long Beach Canine Officers Association.
Good afternoon. My name is Steve Dittmars. I'm a retired police commander, current president of Long Beach Canine Officers Association. Canine Officers Association is the nonprofit that's responsible for raising funds with the help of the community, people like you, to help support our police service dog unit. As someone who spent 6 years as a police service dog handler, I understand the bond between the handler and their canine. You spend many long hours training and patrolling, and then when you finally get home, your partner's still with you. The truth is, you spend more time with your dog than you do your family. For this, you are rewarded with a loving, dedicated partner. The eyes say it all, and they say, "Let's go to work, Dad." On Tuesday, June 28th, we experienced the nightmare of every canine handler, the on-duty loss of a police canine. Although handlers always subconsciously understand that this could happen, you really cannot prepare for it. It devastates not only you, but your family. While you're busy developing your bond with your handler or with your partner, he was also doing the same with your family. When we're at our lowest, others step in and help us stand tall. Our friends, our family, fellow officers, members of the community all step forward to help us share our loss. In reality, it's a loss to us all. One of the things that always made me proudest during my service was the community support that the Police Service Dog Unit received from the city, from Long Beach. This is still true today. As soon as word of the loss of Credo began to spread, members of the community reached out and asked, "How can I help?" Many people went to the association website where they mailed in donations. Several people established GoFundMe pages and other groups raised funds. Some people came here today to make those donations in person. Several groups have asked about raising funds for the purchase of ballistic vests for our canines. We've purchased these in the past. We've found them to be heavy, hot, extremely difficult for the dogs to work in. Ultimately, it's the handler's decision based on everything, the totality of the circumstances, is whether or not we deploy that vest with the dog. As a result of this incident, the police service dog has reevaluated the issue of vests, and they've selected a new product. This product is custom fitted. It offers many of the features the handlers need to effectively deploy their partners. Additionally, it also offers ballistic protection. It's lighter in weight and not as hot as some of the previous models that we've looked at. Please understand, this is not the perfect solution to the problem of protecting our canine partners, but it's an improvement. Since its inception in 1979, the Long Beach Canine Officers Association has been dedicated to raising funds necessary to support the Police Service Dog Unit. At the request of the unit, we are going to purchase 8 custom-fitted ballistic tactical vests for their partners at a cost of almost $30,000. We will also purchase a new partner for Mike when he's ready. Sorry. To conclude, I'd like to thank you all for coming. Thank you for the support you've shown Officer Purcells and the Police Service Dog Unit. And thank you for those who've donated to help keep this the finest unit in the United States. Your support during this time has been essential to us all. Thank you for coming.
And I would like to say thank you, Steve, to you and the Canine Association for all of your support. Especially during this incident, I will forever be grateful to you for being there for me when I needed you. At this time, I'd like to call Canine Officer Mike Woolridge, who will now read the poem, "I Wag My Tail."
Poem called, "I Wag My Tail." The ride is fast, the sirens wail. As cars fly past, I wag my tail. We're finally here, I see the lights. I have no fear, I'm wired tight. My partner, on edge, I know him well. We'll serve our pledge, blue stress I smell. We approach the door, this home I'll comb. It's my solemn chore, my team will go home. My partner shouts, there's no retort, but I have no doubts as I enter the fort. I pick up the scent, my nose he can't foil. Into the darkness I went, smell of gas, anger, fear, gun oil. I'm getting warmer, I've found my man. I round the corner, it hits the fan. The shots ring out, but I charge ahead. My partner shouts, but for this fight, I was bred. The fight is on, but the rounds too many. I did not run, of bravery I had plenty. My legs give out, to the floor I fall. I was the scout, I gave my all. My team moves back, I'm glad they're safe. I took the attack, so my partners, he could not strafe. The room's going dark. never put on the skids because my bite is worse than my bark, and my partner must see his kids. There's one last little four lines. I'll get it. My life was broad. I did not fail. As I see God, I wag my tail.
The Long Beach Honor Guard will now conduct a flag folding ceremony. Would you please stand? Please be seated. And I would ask at this time that the officers from the outside agencies please proceed over to the entrance gate to the academy where you will stage. In Long Beach, all service dogs are cremated and their remains located in a place of honor at the K-9 cemetery on the grounds of our police academy. There will now be a private procession with the Parcells family, the K-9 detail, and their families to place the headstone at the K-9 cemetery on the academy grounds. I'd like to ask everyone to please rise as Credo's remains are carried to his final resting place. And this ceremony will be on the academy grounds, and it will be private for law enforcement and for the families.